I'm Dr. John Bartemus, and this is the Functional Medicine Minute. Many people ask me, why is functional medicine needed? Why is functional medicine necessary? Why is functional medicine growing in popularity? And there's many reasons for that, but the primary reason is that functional medicine operates from one paradigm, whereas mainstream medicine operates from a totally different paradigm. And you'll see today that that difference in paradigms is what makes the difference between the success of functional medicine versus things like chronic disease and inflammatory diseases versus the failure of mainstream medicine versus things like chronic disease and inflammatory diseases. Now, as a chiropractor, I learned in my philosophy, one of our major principles is that there is no process that doesn't take time. And you'll find that functional medicine also honors this principle, that functional medicine realizes that disease develops over time. It doesn't just occur one day. You don't just wake up with cancer. You don't just wake up with autoimmune disease. And when we look at the mainstream medicine paradigm, mainstream medicine basically doesn't really recognize disease until it meets certain diagnostic criteria, and then all of a sudden, now let's do something about it. Well, what about all that time that built up where the person wasn't healthy but wasn't diagnostically diseased yet? That in-between time is the prime area for prevention, for lifestyle change, for living modifications to prevent you from ever getting to the diagnosable disease. And that's where preventative and alternative practices like chiropractic and like functional medicine and like functional neurology come in. So let me show you from a blood work or a lab perspective the difference between functional medicine and mainstream medicine today. Okay? So if this is our range here, whenever you have blood work done, you have a range of values where if you fall within this, which is going to be low, and this end, which is going to be high, as long as you fall within high and low in mainstream medicine, you're normal, okay? So you'll see on your lab test there's a reference range with a high and a low, and as long as you're inside that, your doctor says you're normal. If you're outside one of those, they say, you know, you have an issue or a disease, and here's a drug for that. The problem is that it's not that black and white, okay? So mainstream medicine operates from a black and white paradigm saying, as long as you're anywhere in here, you're okay, okay? If you're there, you're okay. If you're there, you're okay. If you're there, you're okay. You're still not diagnostically diseased yet. But the second you're here, bam, you're high. Let's get you on a drug or let's take action. The problem with that is if this is optimal and this is healthy and this is where we want you to be, if you come in 1 year and get a blood test and you're here, and the second year you're here, and the third year you're here, all 3 years they're saying, yeah, you're okay, you're okay. But the problem is if we look at the trend, you are trending towards sickness, right? Intuitively that makes sense. Same idea, if you're low, 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 you're trending towards sickness on the low end. Well, where functional medicine comes in is functional medicine says, yes, we recognize these black and white, draw the line in the sand criteria where here you're medically okay and here you're medically diagnosed with a disease. We recognize that. But functional medicine will narrow that window saying, okay, here are our lines in the sand. So here's what research has shown is optimal. This is optimal health. This is the number we want to say you are A-okay. You're dead center in the bullseye. But here is our functionally high level that we don't want to see you go past. And here's our functionally low level we don't want to see you go past. So as long as you're within this area, you're okay. And we'd like you ideally at that optimal range. But inside that, you're okay. Once we go outside the functionally high range and outside the functionally low range, then you're trending towards disease, okay? So instead of waiting until, bam, you're diagnosed with hypothyroidism, we'll say, hey, you're outside optimal and you've been trending your last few tests towards hypothyroidism. Should we wait for you to be diagnosed or should we take action to naturally reverse that trend and bring you back towards optimal, back towards balance, back towards homeostasis. So that's the real difference between functional medicine and mainstream medicine. Functional medicine is going to be proactive and preventative and use natural means to support your body's physiology to create health. Mainstream medicine is going to be reactive, let's wait and see, and they don't typically do things until you're diagnosable, and then they say, well, you fit the criteria, so now we can put you on this drug or this surgery. And many times at that point, you're far from reversible or far from getting back to optimal, and you may need a drug for life at that stage. But why would we wait till then and spend so many healthcare dollars doing all this when we could spend pennies on the dollar with prevention and lifestyle change and modification? And that pennies on the dollar will skyrocket the quality of life that you have today and in the future. So this has been your Functional Medicine Minute. If you want to learn more, check me out on my podcast at johnbartemus.com, and I'll talk to you soon. Have a great day.